has three businesses. Our primary business is our selection business, where we make mono paper. We're one of the world's largest paper manufacturers. Then we have Longi Solar, which is our cell and module business. Again, we are now the world's largest module manufacturer with an active capacity of 16 gigawatt currently. And then we have Longi Energy, which is our, we develop power plants in China. This is also to try our new technologies out. So we are selling proven products. So this is a milestone of Longi. We started in 2000. We had our IPO in 2012. And currently, we have a wafer and inputs manufacturing of 36 gigawatt. By the end of this year, it will be up to 50 gigawatt. And we have, like I mentioned before, a module manufacturing of 16 gigawatt, which by the end of 2021, our board actually yesterday passed a clause. We are going to increase our module manufacturing to around 30 gigawatt by 2021 end. So this is just to showcase our position in the wafer market. We have 40% of global shipments in mono wafer, making us the largest player. So in terms of 2018 shipments, Longi was number four globally and number one in the mono market. Just to give you a little brief of the mono crystalline market, when Longi entered this business, the global mono market share was around 2%. This is 5-6 years back. And today the global mono market share globally is over 55% now. And we predict by the end of next year, mono installations will be over 80%. And this is you can see is all the large tier one manufacturers are moving their lines from polycrystalline to mono. So it's a good trend for our wafer business. So this is just to showcase our global presence. We're located in every important country globally, which is present on the solar map. We are headquartered in Xi'an in China, with factories across Malaysia and China. We have five factories in high volume factories in China and a module factory in Malaysia. We are also trying to develop work with the Indian government to start a module and cell manufacturing in India. This is just to showcase our financial performance. We are our market cap is around $13 billion. We are one of the most profitable PV companies in the world with an annual net profit of around $400 million. So we are ranked number one with various agencies, including Bloomberg, Photon, as the most financially stable PV company in the world. So this is again from Bloomberg. They rated us number one in the rest of the world and just after First Solar last year. And this year, they just released a report about a few weeks back. We were number one globally. And this we put in our slides because I think modules being a 25-year product, I think financial health of a company, of a PV company, is the best warranty that one can get. So these are just to showcase some of our customers globally. For our wafer business, all top module companies use our wafer, cell and module companies use our wafer, including Trina, JA, Canadian, Jinko, and for our module business, some of the top names in India are obviously the new Adani, JBM, LightSource, they've all used our product and continue to use our product. So why we are number one is because we spend a lot of money. We are actually one of the largest spenders in the PV industry in R&D. We spent over $550 million to develop our various technologies. We have 526 patents, and we have a dedicated team of around 600 people now working in our R&D team. Another reason why we have a premium product is because we work with the best partners like DuPont, Darius, Henkel, 3M. We put in the best bomb in our products. So this is just to, we currently have the cell efficiency, module efficiency, record with us, and we beat our own record. So constantly for the last 3 years, we've had the cell and module efficiency. So this is some of our products. Now we focus on HIMO 3 and HIMO 4 in India. We are waiting for BIS, so we will have HIBO4 for delivery by January next year. Currently, we are selling our HIBO3 in India, which is a half-cut technology. So, this is just a slide on why half-cut technology is better. It increases power of the module, this reduces the overhead losses. So, this is our HIBO4. It has many benefits, starting with the high solution efficiency. Two people can install the module. Being a 430, the string length is unchanged, so you can have considerable savings in your BOS cost. You can save on cables, mounts, files, foundation installations. Almost around 10 to 15% of BOS savings can be achieved. So this is our warranty. We have industry-leading warranty. So we offer the lowest first-year degradation of less than 2%. And going forward, from the second year onwards, we promise a degradation of nothing more than 0.55% for our half-cut 380. For our bifacial products, the warranty is even better. It's less than 2% in the first year, and going forward, it's 0.45%. Now, this is what we promise. The actual numbers are much, much better. So again, in all of the DNVGL tests, we are always number one or number two. And sometimes we have different products, right? So sometimes number one and number two are both Longi products in their accelerated reliability tests. So we have won the yield test for DNVGL again from DUV for the last 2 years. Another thing we are very proud of is our social responsibility. We believe in being a green company ourselves. We are making a green product, but we try to use green energy through hydro and solar for our own power needs. So this is, we use most of our self-acting are located strategically near large hydro power plants in China. So we use more and more green energy. This is another, our president, Mr. Lee, actually gave a keynote address at the UN Climate Summit, where he launched the Solar for Solar program, where we want to use all solar energy for our power needs. And now we are also, for some of our top clients, we are going and starting a program where we ask them to become completely renewable by, we have two deadlines, 2030 and 2050, and these are large power intensive companies which we are they are signing up with us to go completely renewable. So these are some of our project references. These are some of our India project references.
Why don't you stock anything in India?
We've started stocking our distributor stock in India.
When was this?
From the last 3 months, our distributors have small quantities of this stock.
Who's your distributor?
We have about five distributors. So
this happened recently.
Reddington always used to be stock. But some of our
never had any.
It's always sold out. You have to be first with all that. But I'll take your card and I'll give you the
video. Yeah, sure. Thank you.
Yeah. So
you were saying by next year it will be covering 1800 by Juno.
Yes.
In simple and in short, the plus and minus of Juno versus RD. As far as my knowledge is concerned, it says Mona is good for low temperature area. Not for Rajasthan, not for Delhi, not
it's actually the area. It's actually the opposite. Mono is better in high temperature area also because the heating of the module is less in mono. So the power losses due to heating are less in mono. Mono is just, if you think about it like this, if the top module companies are moving their lines from multi-crystalline to mono-crystalline, some geniuses have thought about this, and they have come to the conclusion that mono is a better business. No, of course, I can share some studies with you. Mono is obviously the better product. If you see, I was talking about the global number when I'm saying it's moving to 80%. In some of the more mature markets, where technology, people pay more money for technology, honestly, and they are ready to pay a higher premium. Countries like Japan, countries like the US, in Europe, they have already moved to mono. No, exactly. For India, you will see now that all the new installations, so if you see 2019, almost 30 to 35, 40% of the installations have been modern.
But you say that cost difference will be make a
I don't think there's any cost difference. There's a very minuscule cost difference. If you're buying a Apple versus Apple, if you're buying a top of the line tier 1 poly to I mean, the prices you hear about, you know, the 21 cent, those are for large customers. If you see the rooftop space, it's very competitive. Longi is very, very competitive.
Cost is almost the same.
Sorry?
Cost is almost the same.
I mean, our product will give you around 5% extra power and about 10% BOS saving. So if you compensate that amount, our cost is the same. So LCOE is the same. Yeah, thank you. Yes, please. See, as I mentioned, in the first year, we promised less than 2%. So Poly will promise you something like less than 3% in the first year. Much lesser than Poly. Much lesser.
You trying the Poly Park also? Because Canadian and REC...
We only made Poly Park. Monopark, sorry.
Monopark.
You only made Monopark.
So, what is the main difference between Polypark and...
So, if you use Longi module, if you use our degradation is lowest in the industry, doesn't matter which module. So, if you use Poly, Mono, Monopark from other people also, our degradation is lowest in the industry, less than 2% in the first year, and 0.55% every year.
Yeah, but in normally in Poly case, it is 0.7% per year.
After the second year.
Yeah, after second year.
Yeah, I'm saying 0.55.
Yeah, I know. That's why I'm saying better than Poly.
Much better than Poly.
Yes. Second is in after the, you say the size will be increased. So it is module mounting frame is used in between because length will increase. So handling problem may be.
It's a small increase. So now we've started using our M6 wafer. Which for anybody who's making a module 400 watt plus is using our M6 paper 90% of the case. So for everybody, the size will increase by that much. It will become an industry standard.
Yeah, because the length will increase, create a problem during the handling time.
No, it will not make. It will be easier to handle, and it will not make any difference in your mounting structure.
Okay.
Yeah. I mean, it will become soon. It will become an industry standard. The size of the module because every company will move above 400 watt if they want to survive in the business.
Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Sir, we are very keen to manufacture in India. The basic premise of manufacturing is that you need to be globally competitive now. Whether I manufacture in India, Bangladesh, America, why is manufacturing moving out of America to China is because they are more competitive. So we are working with the government to make a structure where India can be a competitive market to manufacture. So right now, if you see, I'll just give you small examples. Like in China, the wafer is right very easily available, you know, so you can make the cell. In India, even the cell is not available to make the module. So for your DCR projects, I'm sure you're not able to find any module which is made with Indian cells. Indian cell capacity is 2 gigawatt.
No, what is available?
No, sir, I'm sure, but the government is planning to do 30 gigawatt of projects.
Right.
Right? With 2 gigawatt of cell capacity in 3 years. Mathematics don't add up. I'm Marwadi, I would know. Thank you,
sir.
What
are the issues which will make you competitive?
We are discussing with the government, sir. I mean,
I'll want to add to this discussion. I'm happy to interact with the president of Longi, and I think Longi was one of the front runners, and they took the initiative of putting a 1 gigawatt manufacturing in India. They also bought the land. I think the land is also bought by them. But serious issues like stability of power, which is the very, very important kind of ingredient in cell manufacturing. The cost of power also is one of the major issues. Then the entire ecosystem for cell and module manufacturing needs to grow up. So Longi has been the front runner in embracing and endorsing the Make in India program for our Honorable Prime Minister.
Everybody thinks, every department of the government thinks in their own perspective. Somebody should take a panoramic view to make it all work. Thank you.
Go up to PM level.
Don't you think you've already done it?
That's how we solution this like.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Mohit. So,